Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So I've seen a lot of channels here on YouTube making videos VOD reviewing pros, some watching viewer gameplay and reviewing it, and some even VOD reviewing themselves live on stream or on a YouTube video. However, I've never really seen an in-depth guide on how to actually VOD review, and especially a video on how to do it properly. VOD reviewing can be extremely difficult as a novice to intermediate player, and I've seen a ton of people struggle with it. That's why in this video, I'm not only going to show you how to VOD review, but how to do so properly so you can actually improve as a player as a result of it. There will be multiple different sections in this video, so I'll put the timestamps to each section on screen right now, but I recommend watching the whole thing so you can really get a good understanding of everything. If you guys go on to enjoy this video, I would appreciate it a ton if you could drop a like and consider subscribing if you'd like to see more content just like this. Anyway, without further ado, let's get started. Alright guys, so the first section of this video is understanding VOD reviews. A VOD review comes in one of two types, a first person VOD review or a third person VOD review. First person refers to VOD reviewing yourself, and third person refers to watching pro players and VOD reviewing them to see what you can learn from their gameplay. These two work in conjunction with one another, and proper usage of both can result in some amazing game sense development. Another thing you need to understand before we go any further is the difference between macro and micro actions. It's important to understand these two terms when you VOD review. Micro actions refer to what you do during fights, things like building and editing techniques. Micro actions are typically things you practice in creative, for example, doing a certain phasing technique in a box fight. Macro actions, on the other hand, are the larger actions you make that have a larger impact outside of the fight. These include, but are not limited to, your loot route, rotations, positioning, and anything else that happens to be in the large scope of your game. When doing any sort of VOD review, you want to focus on both micro and macro actions. If you're watching a pro, looking in their micro actions for meta plays, how they handle different engagements, when they do and don't take fights, and the strategies they use to win their fights will benefit you a lot. On the other hand, for macro actions, it'll also benefit you if you look for what they prioritize in their rotations, why they take a certain loot route, what kind of loadouts they run, and other large things like that. When you VOD review yourself, you're looking at more of what you can improve, and not many things that you can actually learn and pick up. That's the major difference between first and third person VOD reviews. In third person VOD reviews, you're looking for new tactics and strategies you can learn and use for yourself. In a first person VOD review, you're more so looking for what you can actually improve on as a player, not really for new things. That's the major difference and why they work so well together when you do both of them. Our next section is choosing what to review. There are two aspects to choosing what you want to VOD review. First, you have to actually decide what VODs you want to watch. This is relatively simple to decide. Just look for the VODs where you aren't sure what you did wrong. If you immediately know after your death both the macro and micro actions that resulted in your death, then there's really nothing to review. Look for VODs where you simply don't understand what you could have done better, what you did wrong, that way you can gain more out of it. Second, you have to decide what you want to look for in that VOD review. I like to make a list of 5 things: rotations, picking fights, positioning, looting, and micros. These 5 factors are what ultimately decide your fate in any game you play. I make a checklist and look for anything I can find in each category. For example, rotations. You could say I should have paid more attention and rotated earlier to first zone before it pushed in on me. For picking fights, you could say I should have avoided this one player because he had better position and I didn't need to 50-50 him for my life. For positioning, you could say I should have looked for height during the sixth zone since it was open during that time and I had materials. For looting, you could just take a different loot route or adjust your path based on where your opponents land. Finally, for micros, just look for anything you did wrong during your actual fight, like boxing up too passively and getting naded, for example. You don't have to fill in every single part of this if you don't find one for everything, but it's good if you can. Once you've found all of your mistakes, or as many as you can possibly find, write them down on an actual piece of paper, like in a notebook, sticky note, or a notepad. Don't do it in your computer, but an actual piece of paper in real life. Write down what you did right, what you did wrong, and how you can actually improve on what you did wrong. That's the number one thing, is to improve on it. For example, if I should have pushed for height on 6th zone, next time I should look at height during 6th zone and see if it's a possibility. The next section of this video is third person reviews. So we've sort of been through what to actually do for a first-person VOD review, but let's consider what to do for a third-person VOD review. Let's start at the beginning of the game, during the looting phase. Analyze where they land, and ask yourself the number one question of VOD reviewing. That question is, why? Why do they take a certain loot route? Does it have better materials, better loot, better positioning? What are the pros and cons of it? Look at when they rotate out based on the zone. Do they have a specific system for it that you might be able to replicate? Once they reach the zone, where do they position themselves? How does this help them later in the game? For picking fights, do they like to fight off spawn? If so, when do they take fights and when do they not? You can ask yourself these questions throughout the game, and for everything you see and analyze, you want to ask yourself how you can replicate it or use it to your advantage. Next, write everything down in the same fashion you did for your own VOD review. This will be important later on, so be sure to actually do it. Next up, we've got comparison. The next step of the VOD review process, and one thing that might help more than you think it will, is to compare the notes for yourself and the notes for the player you VOD reviewed. Compare the positive things each of you do, like the micro actions they do that you might not know, certain rotation strategies they use that you don't, and anything in between. Basically, look for whatever you can find that you and the player don't have in common and that would benefit you if you used it for yourself, and think about whether or not it would help you in-game. Try to also experiment with different things each of you do. While you shouldn't blatantly copy a pro's strategy just because it works for them, there's nothing wrong with merging some aspects of what they do with some aspects of what you do to develop your own unique strategy. One thing you want to look for is sometimes when you're in the same situation as another player and analyze how each of you handle the situation. Look for what one of you did right and that the other person did wrong, and consider adjusting what you do in that situation if what the other player did seems to work better. It's also good to look for a pro who uses your own drop spot so you can analyze the early game and learn from their rotations and other aspects of the game that ultimately result from their early game drop. Alright guys, so that's going to be it for this video. I really hope this video helped you all out. If it did, I'd appreciate it a ton if you could drop a like, and also consider subscribing if you want more Fortnite content just like this. I'd like to quickly shout out my Discord server. I've recently made a lot of changes to it, adding some looking for group sections, an area to discuss Fortnite, daily news updates about everything happening in the Fortnite scene, an area to ask questions and seek advice related to Fortnite, announcements whenever I go live on Twitch or post on YouTube, and so much more coming soon, along with giveaways, which I'm going to be giving away a ton of different stuff, so obviously don't want to miss out on that. I would really appreciate it if you guys could head into the description and join the Discord server. I'm going to be in there pretty often as well, so you might see me in there. I really hope you all enjoyed the video. I appreciate all of your support a ton. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.